فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
Some of you might say, why haven't you add بذل الأسباب and comes with the means? Are you with me? Why didn't you add the definition وبذل الأسباب and it comes with the means? Because that's what you have to do in your reliance, right? In your tawakkul. We'll respond by saying, this is tahqiq now, right? We'll say that this is min sharti, this is from the conditions of tawakkul. And according to the ulama'ul mantiq, a condition is not made part of haqiqatu shay. It's not added to the reality or the definition of something. It's a prerequisite. A prerequisite is outside the definition of something. Are you with me? For example, when you define salah, what do you say? What do you say when you define salah? You say أقوال وأفعال مبدوءة بالتكبير ومختتمة بالتسليم. Where is the niyyah? Where is the niyyah? You say when you define salah, you say speeches and actions that start with Allahu Akbar and that finishes with Salamu Alaikum. Hey, where is the niyyah? Where is the istiqbal al-qibla? Where is all of that gone? Are you with me, brothers? The reason why you don't mention that is because those are shurut, prerequisites that the person has to come with. So that's why we don't mention it in the definition. The author used two ayats, وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَتَوَكَّلُوا إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. The jar and the majroor, which is وَعَلَى اللَّهِ, عَلَى is حَرْفُ جَرْ, Allah is ism majroor. It went before that, فَتَوَكَّلُوا. It should have been فَتَوَكَّلُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ, rely on Allah. But here it said, وَعَلَى اللَّهِ, on Allah, فَتَوَكَّلُوا, rely. It means, the scholars, they say, تَقْدِيمُ مَا حَقُّهُ التَّأْخِيرُ يُفِيدُ الْحَصْرِ. Just because we put the jar and the majroor before the فَتَوَكَّلُوا, a ma'na and a meaning of don't rely on anyone except Allah comes out from this. تَقْدِيمُ, the qa'idah is what? تَقْدِيمُ مَا حَقُّهُ التَّأْخِيرُ يُفِيدُ الْحَصْرِ. Putting forward something that should have been delayed, it should have been put back. If you put it forward, it shows what? It shows exclusivity. Like it was meant to be na'budu iyyaka. Na'budu is the fi'il. Na'budu is the fi'il. The fa'il is dhamir mustatir. Taqdiruhu nahnu. Iyyaka is the maf'ul bih. In the Arabic language, that's how the context works. It's a fi'ilun, fa'ilun, wa maf'ulun bih. But what happened here, the object which is the maf'ulu bih went before the fi'il and the fa'il. The reason is because taqdeemu ma haqquhu ta'akhir yufidul hasr. Exclusivity is what we're looking for here. We don't want to worship anybody other than Allah. We're trying to say, oh Allah, you alone we worship. That's why the author brought that ayah. Wa qawluhu ta'ala, the statement of Allah, wa man yatawakkal ala Allahi fahuwa hasbuh. And anyone who relies on Allah, fahuwa hasbuh. ما معنى فهو حسبه؟ It means فهو كافيه. فهو حسبه means فهو كافيه. Allah is enough for you. You don't need anybody else. Have you relied on Allah? Leave it for Him. Allah is there for you. There's no one you need to rely on after that. And we mentioned the famous story of who? Fir'aun and how he was killing. Allah says, طاسم من تلك آيات الكتاب المبين نتلو عليك من نبأ موسى وفرعون بالحق لقوم يؤمنون إن فرعون علا في الأرض وجعل أهلها شيعا يستضعف طائفة منهم يذبح أبناءهم ويستحي نساءهم إنه كان من المفسدين إنه كان من المفسدين صح. He was one who brought corruption to the earth. He killed the women, the children, he saved their women, everything. Allah then says, ونريد أن نمن على الذين استضعفوا في الأرض ونجعلهم أئمة ونجعلهم الوارثين ونمكن لهم في الأرض ونري فرعون وهامان وجنودهما. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to take Bani Israel out of what Fir'aun was doing to them. And of course then the story of Musa takes place. He was killing boys. The boy Nabiullah Musa, he grew up in whose house? Whose house did Musa grow in? The man who was killing the young children, the young boys, was killing them. Musa grew up in his house. He raised him. Allah wants to show you his ability. To show you how fa'alu lima yurid. He does whatever he wishes. He allowed him to grow in his... Are you with me, brothers? And he grew. Fir'aun, when he became Musa, when he grew, before that, who was he brought back to? His mother. He refused. وَحَرَّمْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَرَاضِعَ مِنْ قَبْلُ. Allah says, we prohibited him from taking the breast milk of any other woman. Allah wanted to... He brought him back to his mom. And not only that, his mom was getting paid to breastfeed her own child now. Alhamdulillah. She brought her son back and she's getting money for it. And he's protected. No one can catch Musa. He's growing in the best household. In the sense where? Rich money. Fir'aun was raising him. And Asiya, righteous woman, raised him. Nabiullah Musa, that's how he grew. This is Allah. When you rely on him, things you think cannot happen. It's impossible. It can't happen. وَمَا كَانَ عَطَاءُ رَبِّكَ مَحْذُورًا. Your Lord's giving is not prevented. Wallahi, Allah's treasures is big. Don't ever think to yourself, Allah's giving is limited. And it can stop at a particular point. Allah is there, subhanahu wa ta'ala, for you. If you show him that you rely on him. I'tibad. Scholars mention the battle of Uhud. The Prophet ﷺ, his front teeth was broken. Some of the scholars, they mention that the reason why it was broken is to show you that nobody is above pain and hardship. And no one that Allah created is always open and vulnerable for attacks and harm, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's face. No one can harm him. Nabiullah Muhammad, bleeding, the best of creation in which Allah ta'ala created. So you as a person are going to go through hardships, rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believe in him. Know he's the one who controls your affairs. Nasiyati biyadik. My affairs is in your hands, O Allah. Then the author brings the fifth ibadah, which is ar-raghba. And then he brings the sixth ibadah, which is rahba. And then he brings the seventh ibadah, which is khushu'. And he brings a dalil for them. Don't worry, I'll explain each one. The author that brings all three of them, he brings one dalil for it. إِنَّمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ. He brings one dalil for all of them. The reason why he brought them all is because they share the same dalil. All of them share the same dalil. Raghba, what does it mean, shara'an? It means iradatu is to intend and want. It means to want. Iradatu mardatillahi. It is to intend Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being pleased with you. Iradatu mardati Allahi fil wusuli ila al-maqsoodi mahabbatan lahu wa raja'a. Is iradatu mardati Allah. It is wanting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be pleased with you. Fil wusuli ila al-maqsoodi, in reaching your objective. مَحَبَّةً لَهُ, in love of him. وَرَجَاءً, and in a state of hope from him. رَهْبَ means فِرَارُ الْقَلْبِ, that your heart runs إِلَى اللَّهِ, to Allah. ذُعْرًا وَفَزَعًا, your heart runs to Allah تبارك وتعالى in a state of fear. مَعَمَلِ مَا يُرْضِيهِ, whilst you are doing what pleases him. وَالْخُشُوعِ لِلَّهِ, and also خُشُوع for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does that mean shara'an? It means فِرَارُ الْقَلْبِ إِلَى اللَّهِ ذُعْرًا وَفَزَعًا, it means that the heart runs to Allah in a state of fear, مَعَ الْخُضُوعِ لَهُ, whilst in a state of humility. All three of them, one evidence is what he gave for them. إِنَّهُمْ, the previous aforementioned prophets, يُسَارِعُونَ, they will hasten فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ, in the good. وَيَدْعُونَنَا, and they will supplicate to us. رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ. All three of them are mentioned in there. Then the author brings the third, the eighth ibadah, which is khashya. And the evidence that he brings for it is فَلَا تَخْشَوْهُمْ وَخْشَوْنِي. What does khashya mean? Khashya means فِرَارُ الْقَلْبِ إِلَى اللَّهِ, the heart runs to Allah in a state of fear. مَعَ الْعِلْمِ, whilst you have knowledge, بِهِ وَبِأَمْرِهِ, you have knowledge of Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and His command. You run to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, فِرَارُ الْقَلْبِ, the heart runs to Allah, إِلَى اللَّهِ ذُعْرًا وَفَزَعًا, in state of fear. مَعَ الْعِلْمِ بِهِ, with knowledge of His, with knowledge of Him. وَبِأَمْرِهِ, and also knowledge of His command. The ninth that the author brings, the ninth ibadah, is al-inaba. Al-inaba means shara'an in the sharia, رُجُوعُ الْقَلْبِ, the heart turning back to, إِلَى اللَّهِ, to Allah, مَحَبَّةً وَخَوْفًا وَرَجَاءً, in a state of love, fear and hope. And the author brings قوله تعالى, the statement of Allah, وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ, turn back to your Lord, وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ, and surrender to Him. Then the author brings the tenth ibadah, which is al-isti'ana. And the evidence that he brings for it is إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. And the hadith, إِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. Isti'ana means what? طَلَبُ الْعَوْنِ, is to seek help. مِنَ اللَّهِ, from Allah. طَلَبُ الْعَوْنِ مِنَ اللَّهِ, it is to seek help from Allah. فِي الْوُصُولِ إِلَى الْمَقْصُودِ, to attain your goal and objective. The word عَوْنِ is مُسَعَدَة. طَلَبُ الْعَوْنِ مِنَ اللَّهِ فِي الْوُصُولِ إِلَى الْمَقْصُودِ. And the evidence that he brought for this is what? إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ, you alone, O Allah, we worship. وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, and you alone we seek help from. وَفِي الْحَدِيثِ, and also in the hadith, that the Prophet said to Abdullah ibn Abbas, إِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ, if you ask help from anybody, فَاسْتَعِمْ بِاللَّهِ, ask help from Allah alone. وَلِذَلِكَ the Salaf وَهَذِي الْأُمَّةِ, the pious predecessors, the Sahabas, the Tabi'in, and the Tabi'u Tabi'in, they would never ask anybody for something. That if one of them dropped their stick for their riding beast, they would go down by themselves and get it. They would never ask the one who was on the ground to go get it for them. They would just go down themselves and get it. All of that is because فَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِمْ بِاللَّهِ, they felt shy asking from anybody other than Allah. Then the author, the 11th ibadah which he brought is al-isti'adah. Isti'adah means talabul awdhi, is to seek refuge. The word al-awdh, it means al-iltija. The word awdh means iltija. طلب العوذ is to seek refuge. من الله, from Allah. ورود المخوف, when something fearful occurs to you. طلب العوذ من الله, from Allah. عند ورود المخوف, when something scaring you occurs. So what's the difference between isti'adha and isti'ana? Isti'ana is asking Allah for help in everything. Isti'adha, on the other hand, is only when it is a state of fear. And that is, the dalil for it is قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. The word al-falaq means as-subh. Al-falaq means what? As-subh, the morning. Oh Allah, say to them, Muhammad, أَعُوذُ, I seek refuge. بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ, the Lord of the morning. وَقَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى, and also the statement of Allah, قُلْ, say, أَعُوذُ, I seek refuge, بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, the Lord of the people. Then the author then brings the 12th ibadah, which is istighatha. And istighatha means طلب الغوث من الله, seeking refuge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طلب الغوث من الله, seek refuge from Allah. طلب الغوث من الله, from Allah. عند ورود الضرر, عند ورود الضرر, when harm afflicts you. So what's the difference between isti'ana and isti'ada and istighatha? Isti'ana is seeking refuge, seeking help from Allah to attain your objective and your goal. Isti'ada is seeking refuge from Allah in something you fear. You're scared of something. It may not even be harmful, but you're scared of it. You're in a dark room, you go, A'udhu Billah. And then it might be a surprise from your wife. Eid Mubarak. Yeah? This is not a... You were scared. So you seek refuge in who? In Allah. And isti'ana means seeking refuge from Allah in something that is harmful. The 13th ibadah is al-dhabhu. Al-dhabhu, which means qat'u al-hulqumi. It is to cut the jugular vein. It is to cut. قَطْعُ الْحُلْقُومِ, to cut the jugular vein. وَالْمَرِيِّ, and the way the blood comes out from. Is the jugular vein where the blood comes out? No, it's where the person dies from, right? No. The jugular vein is the aorta, they call it. Aorta, right?
Yeah,
it's not, right? So which one is the blood?
The blood comes out of the jugular vein.
It comes out from the jugular vein. And what about the aorta?
The aorta is just it's the main artery.
Does blood come out for it?
Yeah, blood comes out for
it. It comes out for
it.
Okay, so
the
which one
is the main one?
It's the main one. Yeah. And then the hulqum is the aorta. The reason I laugh when I say aorta, it's because Somalis, there's, yeah, Yuto? Yeah, you guys know it, right? It's something that Somalis do. It's called, in English, I think it's called pardoning, right? Pardon. Yeah?
Money triangle.
Money triangle. It's basically based, every month, you bring £10, you bring £10, you bring £10, you bring, and then you give it to one person. I know you guys have it as well. What's it called? Yeah? Committee. Yeah, inshallah. It's ajeeb, Allah. Have you realized how trustworthy these people are? Yeah? No one knows. Only one person or two people know that person, and the money's always be booked correctly. Allahu Akbar. Anyways, قَطْعُ الْحُلْقُومِ وَالْمَرِيِّ. It's the aorta and the jugular vein. From who, lakin? مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ. It's cutting it from the بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ. Behemoth and Anam are only three animals: camel, goat, and a what? and a goat. Camel, cow, and goat. Goat, a lamb, all of that fall under there. Are you with me? It's three only. Behemotul and Amma are only. It's cattle. Huh? Sheep, all of that falls under the goat. Because sheep, it differs from land to land. Some people, countries don't have sheep. Because their countries are very hot. So it's a goat, it looks. And here it has a sheep. It's the same family, basically. They're all the same. They're brothers and cousins. Yeah. Oh, look alike. Oh, Somalis look alike. Yeah, it's like that. They're all. One's got a black head. I'm talking about the goats, okay, the camel. And the goats. The lambs. Somali, we call the one with the black head. Who knows what's it called in Somali? Yeah? The one with the black head. Hey, Somali. Gulet. Hey, yeah. Ido. Have you guys ever heard of Ido? Mohammed, did you know it? Yeah, you guys have to learn the language. Mm-hmm. Behemotul an'am specifically is when you're talking about dhabh, slaughtering, it's these three. It is those three. Okay? Dhabh is not called a chicken. Are you with me? This definition. You don't get closer to Allah by this definition of the Sheikh. You don't get closer to Allah by slaughtering what? Are you with me, brothers? The taqarrub ila Allah is these three. That's behemotul an'am specifically. We have to do tafsir of this mas'ala more in Kitab al-Tawheed, inshaAllah. So it's qat'ul hulqumi wal mari'i. It's cutting the throat, the jugular vein, the aorta, all of it. تَقَرُّبًا إِلَى اللَّهِ. The reason you're doing it is to get closer to Allah. عَلَى صِفَةٍ مَعْلُومَةٍ in a well-known way. So it's قَطْعُ الْحُلْقُومِ وَالْمَرِيِّ مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ تَقَرُّبًا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى صِفَةٍ مَعْلُومَةٍ. In a well-known way is how you're doing it. Then the 14th one, which the author mentioned, which is the last one, is a nadar. Nadar. The nadar is of two types. It has two meanings in the Sharia. We can't just give one definition like that. It has two. The first one is ta'rif, which is am, a generic, general meaning. And that is ilzam al-abdi nafsahu. امتثال خطاب الشرعي. The first nadar is إلزام العبد نفسه. A person obliges on himself. He obliges on himself. He makes it mandatory on himself. امتثال خطاب الشرعي, to follow the addressing of the Sharia. In other words, following the religion of Islam. The second one is إلزام العبد نفسه. The person, he makes it mandatory and obligatory on themselves. إلزام العبد نفسه لله, for Allah. نفلا لله, نفلا معينا غير معلق. This person, he makes it obligatory on himself, something that was voluntary. It's not obligatory, it's not fard. This wasn't wajib on him asalatan, it was sunnah. Mu'ayyanan means specifically. He specifically narrows this sunnah down to a specific one. So he doesn't generally make it general. It has to be specific. It also has to be mu'allaqin. It can't be in exchange of something. It can't be ala which al-iwad. In exchange of something, ala muqabala. For example, if he says lillahi alayya, it's upon me, for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, in shafiya maradi, that he cures my illness, and asuma thalathata ayyamin, I'm going to fast 3 days. This one, la yu'rafuhu qurbatan. This is not one you get closer to Allah by it. No. This is exchange for something. Are you with me? Because it happened ala wajhi al-iwad wal muqabala. The one we're talking about is when it's done and what? It's done with the not the purpose of iwad or muqabala. The person just independently does it. So if these three conditions are there, naflan, mu'ayyanan, غَيْرَ مُعَلَّقٍ, it's voluntary, it's specific, it's not exchange, then it becomes a ibadah, يُتَقَرَّبُ بِهَا إِلَى اللَّهِ, which you can get closer to Allah with. Now, we'll take a break inshaAllah ta'ala, 10 minutes, we'll carry on.